Throughout the process of creating this starter guide, I've had access to some n8n insiders who shared some pretty cool tips and tricks with me that I'm going to share with you to help you along your journey of becoming a skilled n8n flow grammar. Hey there, it is I versus AI, and this is the Node reference library that I've talked about throughout this starter guide, which is available for you along with a lot of other goodies that you can use, including prompts and links to templates. That's all linked down below in the description and the pinned comment. But this Node reference library that I've shown you is not only a reference library for you, but it is a reference library for a large language model. The secret and power of n8n is its ability to be copied and pasted directly into a large language model. For example, if you wanted to ask a large language model all about the AI agent nodes, or the data transformation nodes, or the flow and core nodes, you could simply take these nodes. I'm just going to hit Command or Control C on my keyboard, head over to ChatGPT or Claude from Anthropic, or even Google's new Gemini 2.5 Pro and AI Studio. All of the models are very well versed on JSON objects, which is what this is. Structured text is readable for a model, whereas this is readable and understandable for a human. And the real tip here is you can give these nodes to a large language model and ask it to help you understand them. Along with looking at the docs, this link is available at the top right-hand part of the settings here. This link takes you to the docs for that particular node. You can give this to a large language model along with your vision of what it is that you want a workflow to do. You can even start with just saying, I am struggling with this aspect of my business, my finances, or my personal life that I think could be automated away. I could automate that pain away. And let me tell you, it is amazing to watch a model reason through, output the JSON that you simply copy and paste right into the canvas in n8n, saving you so much trouble. So use the Node reference library. It's not just for you to understand the nodes that are available with n8n, but they are for you to give to a large language model to understand the nodes that are available to help you build your workflows. Workflows like the workflow we built in part 3 of this starter guide, that every morning at 9 a.m. grabs the current weather, formats that weather, and sends you an email. And this workflow looks fairly simple. It's just got 5 nodes. When you're getting to know n8n and you're looking at other YouTubers or perhaps n8n on Reddit, the subreddit, you're going to see some pretty wild, pretty cool workflows. And if you're anything like me, you're going to think, wow, it would be amazing if I could build those workflows. And you can start simple, because simple workflows are the workhorses in your n8n instance. They do wonderful things that are just simple, that solve your problem, and they are extensible. It's a great idea to have the weather sent to you every morning at 9 a.m. in your Gmail. You wake up, you take a look at it, you know how to dress for the day. It's a very simple automation. This workflow has a node here that simplifies the weather data returned from the API. Let's run the automation and take a look. And we'll see these JSON expressions, which we covered in part 2 of the starter guide on how to read these. And to remind you as to how these JSON expressions end up here in the settings area of a node, I'm going to delete this expression and bring it back in by dragging it into the node. It automatically forms an expression, and this got me for months when I was learning n8n until I finally learned how to read these JavaScript expressions, which I've talked about in part 2. But a quick reminder is that this $JSON is shorthand. It basically means the previous node. That's it. It means whatever node is the previous node has information in it in a box called current. And inside that box is an item called temperature. But what if you decide that you want to add another node to this work? You want to add a node that gets the date and time. Let's get the current date. It's a simple node. We'll test the step. There's the current date. And now all of our expressions are broken. It's a good idea to get into the habit of directly referencing the node that you are getting the data from. In our analogy of a train moving through the train stations being the same as data moving through nodes, we want to reference the specific train station on which the data we're looking for was placed in the baggage car. And to do that, we need a parentheses, specifically the left parentheses. Hitting the left parentheses will pull up this helpful menu, which allows you to reference the data specifically. But it will still be red because it is not 100% correct syntax for the JSON expression. Let's add a period, which will then open up the helpful menu again. And the suggestion is correct. We want an item. Let's separate item and JSON with a period, and our syntax is correct. I mentioned this in part 4 of the starter's guide, but having a large language model write your notes field is really great for keeping your workflows organized. I suggest that you ask the model to write what the node does, what data flows into the node, what data flows from the node, and which node that data flows to. Because once you get your automation all set up, running well, nicely named, notated, you're going to want to back it up, which is my next tip. On the home screen of your n8n instance, you can create folders, which actually, this is my next tip. Before I teach you about backing up workflows, creating a folder here is very simple. Simply name your folder, click on the menu item for a workflow, click Move to Folder, and search for the folder you wish to move the workflow to. I've created an admin folder where I have backups of my credentials and workflows. I love these workflows. They're very simple to set up and they work really well. And they run every 2 hours backing up my workflows and my credentials. Trust me, you do not want to lose either one of those because they would be, for one, with the workflows, irreplaceable. And for the credentials, very painful to set up again. But because these two workflows run on a schedule and my YouTube Notes workflow runs on a schedule where it checks for a new playlist every few minutes, because I don't want my executions to be filled with successful calls that are just automations running on a schedule. You can see that automations that are manual, such as the simple weather report that I've been showing you, are not the same as simple workflows where the success is automated. So to solve that problem, here's another quick tip. In the top right-hand corner in the menu, head to Settings on a workflow, and under Save Successful Production Executions, click Do Not Save. This means that any execution in which there was an error will still show up on the execution log, but the execution log will not be filled with numerous every minute or every 2 hour execution success notices. I mentioned that I did not make those two backup to GitHub workflows. I got them here on the n8n site under templates, in which the n8n team has curated templates from the community, over 1,600 as of this recording, templates, many of which are free. These templates are anything from extremely simple to very, very complex. Like this trending template by Jim, who's one of the n8n insiders that helped me during the process of creating this video. Thank you, Jim. And he creates templates that are amazing, absolutely amazing. And you can see any of the templates that Jim has published by clicking to explore You can zoom to fit. Hold down your middle mouse button to move around and take a closer look, just like in your normal n8n instance. And you can also use this template by clicking Use for Free, where if you are not signed in, you can get started free with the n8n cloud. If you are self-hosting, that will also show up here too. If it does not, you can simply download the template, which is nothing more than, again, a JSON object, and you can import it into a blank canvas under Import from File. The self-hosting installation docs are helpful too and give you a lot of information on the difference between the community edition and tells you what it does not include, which might lead you to believe that the community edition is less than the edition that you get from using Cloud, Pro, or Enterprise. But the community edition has features that are not available on Cloud, like the ability to add community nodes, nodes that are not native to n8n that are created by the community. When you register the community edition, you'll get access to folders, debug and editor, which believe me is absolutely essential when you're building workflows, and also workflow history. Believe me, when you make a mistake and want to go back to a previous state, this workflow history is a game changer. n8n has written guides for three different self-hosting options. I am using DigitalOcean for $8 a month. You have a base rate of $6 a month. I upgraded the SSD drive and the memory available for my instance. My instance runs perfectly. My workflows run perfectly on time, no hiccups. But if you would like an even simpler option for self-hosting, I'm going to link in the description a video by Ben who shows you how to get started hosting on Railway for $5 a month and one click. Self-hosting with DigitalOcean is not hard. The n8n team has written a very well done guide. Give it to ChatGPT and ask it to help you. I got set up in an evening creating a droplet on DigitalOcean and had my server up and running. I chose to go with DigitalOcean because of the ability to add features like FFmpeg or YouTube download, both of which are Python tools, to my instance, so I could add those to my workflows, which is not available on Railway. Railway is a great place to start your self-hosting journey. It's inexpensive and it's one click. But if you want more extensibility in your server, I do recommend DigitalOcean. So we're back where we started, with an empty canvas and an invitation to take the first step on your journey to becoming a skilled n8n flow grammar. If you've jumped into the starter guide for AI enthusiasts at this video and want to start from the beginning, I've got you covered. That video is on screen right now.